Some of these nasal vaccine candidates are given as boosters after the initial set of shots, but doctors say they could be used as primary vaccinations in the future.
A jab could soon become a sniff. Several companies are in clinical trials on a nasal COVID vaccine.
It's an attractive way of delivering a vaccine, and it also will stimulate your immune system in a different way because there are distinct antibodies that get generated when you're immunizing someone in their nose versus immunizing someone in their muscle like an injection does.
Dr. Amesh Adalja with the Johns Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health says the COVID nasal vaccine is not a live virus like the nasal vaccine for the flu. Rather, it delivers the same spike protein you get from the shot in a different way. And it could be more effective at preventing infection and spreading the virus because you get infected through membranes in your nose and mouth.
If you vaccinate someone with a nasal vaccine, you would anticipate them forming antibodies in their nose, which might be more protective at preventing infection, preventing transmission, because a lot of the action is happening in the nose, and that's just not where our current vaccines provide a lot of immunity.
Another benefit, it's much easier to administer, so doctors think it could increase vaccinations in certain populations.
There are many people that have needle phobia. There are many parts of the world where they may not have the resources available to do syringes and needles and all of that. This is something that's easy, has a much easier way of delivery than traditional vaccines as well.
Dr. Adalja says there are at least a dozen nasal vaccine candidates all over the world, some already in phase 3 clinical trials.
It may be the case that these vaccines become available in other parts of the world before they're available in the U.S., and I think that's going to be the most likely scenario.
Dr. Adalja says it will be at least 6 months before any nasal COVID vaccine is on the market. In downtown Baltimore, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.